Welcome back to my channel. For those of you new here, my name is Suzanne, and today we're talking tomatoes. And the reasons why actually we might want to pick them early rather than leaving them to ripen on the vine. And there's five reasons why I do this. And that's because the first one is I grow all my tomatoes outside. I don't have a greenhouse, and I live in zone 8, temperate UK. And so my growing season is relatively short. I have to start my tomatoes off inside, get them transplanted. And so when we're talking about days to maturity, that's very different to days to ripeness. So here we have a mature tomato, but as you can see, it's not ripe compared to this one of the same variety on the same stem, which is getting ripe. Now, when they talk about days to maturity, that means either from when you've sown the seed directly in the ground or from when you transplant it. Because when you transplant your little seedling, it goes dormant for a while and then it has to start regrowing because it goes into shock. And so what we have to do when we've started them off inside where there's no wind and there's no drastic temperature changes is that we have to acclimatise them to going outside. That can take a few weeks, especially here in the UK where our weather is quite temperamental to say the least. Then they have to get in the ground where the nighttime temperatures here can be very low compared to our daytime temperatures. Then these poor little plants have to get growing, set their fruit, and deal with maybe having a heat wave for a week, then going into cold weather. And all of this impacts the way that our poor little plants actually set these fruit, let alone get to maturity. And it can take just as long for these mature tomatoes to ripen as it does for the plant to actually get them on there in the first place. So for someone like me, who grows them outside, my first frost date is mid-October, but I can get air frosts as early as August, or I might not get any frosts at all. It's a waiting game. But here's another reason why I might want to get my tomatoes in early. And that's because I live in an exceptionally humid place. And with humidity brings disease. And one of our biggest diseases with tomatoes is blight. And I live in an exceptionally high risk area for blight. And it comes in late blight on the wind. And so once it starts hitting our area, it might not even matter if you grow your tomatoes in a greenhouse or a high tunnel. Once it starts, it might hit everything. Now, one thing you can do to try and mitigate that is to grow plants that are blight resistant. And one of those that I have here are these little lovelies. Now, this is the Brad Gates Barry's Crazy Cherry. And this is one of the most blight resistant varieties that I grow in my garden. I've had this along with the Brad's Atomic Grape, and I've had these go right through into November with fruits still on the plant and not be touched by the blight when they've wiped everything else out in my garden. Now, as you can see here, I have quite a few different varieties. This one here is Carbon. These ones up here are Persuasion. These ones here are Sergeant Pepper. This is Tumbling Tiger. This is Sungold. These ones are another, Mazzacotca, I think these ones are. So we've got Brad's Crazy Cherry. Then here are the three Brad Gates new varieties for 2023. They were released in 2022, ready for this season. So this is Golden Hour, Mini Mazzano, and then Tim's Taste of Paradise out of the three. These two are dwarf varieties, and I've trialled these two by having them indoors in a walled, sort of like they're a wall hanging basket type thing. I've neglected them by putting them in my cold frame and just left them to it. And I've had this one, the Golden Hour, in ground. And I have to say, these two varieties are superb. But out of them, this Mini Marzano is absolutely delicious. The Tim's Taste of Paradise is a vine, and I've grown that in ground. It's wonderful. I'm not a huge tomato fan, so this one out of the three wasn't my favourite, but I gave seed to a friend. She gave one of the plants to her neighbour. He says it's the best tasting cherry tomato he's ever tasted, so there's some recommendation. Up here we have Sweet Tooth and Street Lightning. So that's just some of the tomatoes that I've grown this year. I've grown a few others that are not on this table. Now, the other reason to take these early is, like with these carbon and the persuasion is another Brad Gates out of all tomato producers. He's one of my favourite, well, he is my favourite producer. These carbon are hailed as one of the best tasting tomato. It's the first time I've grown these, and I got the seed from Tomato Revolution. They're a fantastic seed company here in the UK, not affiliated or sponsored by them in any way. But what my son and I found in a taste test, so here's number three. These varied greatly in their taste, because when tomatoes ripen, they ripen from the inside out, and they produce a gas called ethylene, which is actually a hormone, and that starts the ripening process. So as you can see with this one, once this tomato starts ripening, it will encourage all the others around it. Bananas do the same. You can see these are starting to blush. Soon as these ripen, starting to ripen like this and starting to blush, it's the best time to get them off the vine. And the reason for that is this. You can see that these are actually wrinkling, but it's because these swelled suddenly with the amount of rain that they got. Now, this is one of two things that they'll do. They'll either swell suddenly and wrinkle with the rain, or they'll do this and crack. Now, all that rain influences the way these tomatoes taste. And that's what we found with these. They're absolutely stunning. But they'd absorbed so much water that, as you can see, they're starting to crack. But also, it greatly influenced the taste on them. Now, I'm lucky in that I grow so many different varieties, purely because, as I said, I'm not a huge raw tomato fan. But I grow a lot of them forever searching for that one that's going to blow me away. But also because we like tomato soup, and so all of these get chopped up together and processed frozen to just pull straight out of the freezer ready for soups. So when you combine them all, then, you know, they balance each other out. So that's another reason to get them picked early. You don't want to lose fruits that you've got by waiting. So that's the third one. Now, another reason to get them in is pests. This is one of the Golden Hour, and this is from one that was grown in ground, and that damage there is from the woodlice, the roly-polies. People think that they're great for the garden, that they're composters and that they'll get rid of decayed things and what have you. Not everyone knows that actually they cause damage in soft fruits like strawberries, but they'll also nibble at things like radishes, which are one of my most favourite things to grow. And if you've got issues in the crown of your strawberries, it's most likely them that's doing it. So that's another reason why I like to get them off. Also, my squirrel, which I've mentioned in another video, she likes to have a nibble. And the birds, not so much on tomatoes like this. I mean, you may get them, but anything red, your birds will go after your strawberries and things like that. So they particularly like things that are red. So as soon as they're getting ripe, you know, especially in warm weather when they're after the moisture, they're going to go for these nice, anything that looks fantastic. Squirrels, they're going to go after your very best fruits. So again, another reason to get them in. Now, once you've got them all in, I touched slightly on something else. This is one of my baskets. And I already mentioned the Barry's Crazy Cherry. And it's not crazy for no reason. This is full of the crazy cherries. It's a multiflora, so it puts on huge, huge trusses. And as you can see, some of them are indeed yellow and ripe, and others of them are green. Now, what I figured out is that one of my most favourite ways to eat tomatoes is green and pickled. So the fifth way that you want to get your tomatoes in early is because you want to process and preserve them. And these little nuggets are just absolutely amazing pickled. If you've never tried it, you really want to. Even the yellow ones, even ripe, although the ripe ones will be a lot softer because you're using a hot brine to pickle them. And I need to put this down because it's seriously heavy. Oh, excuse me. So, fried green tomatoes are amazing. Chutneys, again, amazing. But there are also lots of other things that you can do with green tomatoes if you've got to get them in early. Better to get things in early than lose an entire crop. But I also tested out something else because I was told many years ago that the way to know that your tomatoes were ready for harvesting was that they had to blush. Then I was told, oh, they had to be a pale green as opposed to a dark and shiny green, that once they'd gone a matte colour, that's when they were ready. But I used to grow black crim because that is actually today my favourite beefsteak. And a couple of years ago, I had one come off the plant and it was, to all intents and purposes, nowhere near ready to harvest. So I stuck it on my windowsill. I wanted to put this theory to test. And indeed, it sat there the whole season. And I'm sorry, you can see my hand moving. It's a thing, I talk with my hands as a general rule. So anyway, it sat there the whole season. And I did all of this because in this room, I've got double aspect windows. They're very deep. And so my tomatoes come in and sit on this windowsill to ripen. So it sat there amongst all these other tomatoes, and all the other tomatoes ripened around it. And eventually it got to the point where I thought, oh, poor little tomato, it's true. If it's dark green and it's shiny and it comes off the plant, it's a goner. It's not going to ripen. But, surprise, surprise, eventually this tomato did indeed ripen because it was in a dry environment. There were no diseases around. There were no blemishes on it for it to get anything to perish, and it did indeed ripen, and it didn't taste any different to the others that had ripened later. Now, I'm not saying that's going to happen for every tomato that falls off your plant, but I'd at least give them a chance. So there we go. There's my five reasons why I pick my tomatoes early and I get them in. And I just realised that I didn't have all my tomatoes in shot. And right up here is another one called Big Mama. And that was my latest to go in, because like I've mentioned before in other videos, everything of mine went in late this year. I had negative things impacting. And so none of those have come off the plant ripe, but I've pulled them in early anyway, in the hope that they will ripen. And living up to its name, this is indeed Super Mama, sorry, it's called, not Big Mama. But yeah, to say how late it went in, I'm quite impressed with how many it put on the plant. But I shall wait and see what it does. And if they don't ripen, they'll still get used. So I hope you find this useful. I hope you'll like, subscribe, and share, and I hope to see you again soon. Bye for now.